My name is Katie, and this is Crafty Corner. Today, we are going to be doing three activities together that all have one thing in common, the balloon. Now, before each activity begins, I'm going to let you know what supplies that you need so that you can be ready to follow along. Are you ready to join me? Let's do it. The first one is what I like to call inflatable monsters. What you're going to need to do this is a balloon, baking soda, white vinegar, and an empty bottle. I'm just using a water bottle right here. First step that you need to do is you're going to very carefully pour some white vinegar into the bottom of your bottle. Now you don't need to put too much in, just around two fingers worth or so. So very carefully, we're gonna pour that in. If you need to use a funnel, you could ask your grown-up for help. You're gonna very carefully pour that into the bottle right there. There we go. That's two fingers up from the bottom. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take my baking soda and I'm going to measure out about one tablespoon. So I have my tablespoon measuring spoon right here. I'm going to put in some baking soda. Now I'm holding it over a tray so that I don't make a mess of my table. And that's probably a very good idea to do. There we go. I have one tablespoon of baking soda. Then the next step is my favorite part. I'm going to blow up my balloon, but I'm not going to tie it or anything like that. I'm just going to stretch it out. That just helps stretch it out. So it makes the next step a little bit easier. Now, I had a little bit of help with this step, and I suggest that you get some help too. You're going to put your two fingers inside the top of the balloon, and you are going to stretch it open so it makes an opening at the top. Then with your very special helper, you are going to pour that tablespoon of baking soda into your balloon very carefully. And you'll have a balloon just like this. So, here's my balloon, and inside there, so if I give it a squish, you can kind of tell, there's some baking soda sitting at the bottom. Are you ready for the special part? You might need some help holding your bottle. You're going to stretch your balloon open, and you're going to place it very carefully over the top of your bottle, like so. There you go, can you see that? So I have my bottle, I have my white vinegar at the bottom, and I have my balloon over the top of the opening with the balloon with the baking soda in it. Does everyone see that? Perfect. Is I'm going to count down from three, and when I say go, you are going to lift the bottom end of your balloon up. 3, 2, 1, and lift it up. Would you look at that? Is yours doing it too? That's so cool! I wonder why that's happening though. Can you see that cool fizzy action inside the bottle? That's cool to look at too. So what do you think is happening right now? Let's take a look at it. So when I tipped the baking soda into the vinegar, it started fizzing. And that's what we call a chemical reaction. Now, as a result of that chemical reaction, a gas, which is something that we can't see, like the air we breathe, was being released. That gas is called carbon dioxide. And because that gas had nowhere to go but into the balloon got filled with that gas and inflated all by itself. How amazing is that? Science is awesome. Now, what I want you to do is I want you to try this experiment again. But what's going to happen if you use more vinegar and less baking soda? Or what about if you use less vinegar and more baking soda? Do you think that might have an effect on how quickly the balloon fills or how big the balloon gets even? Try it out and let me know what happens. I can't wait to see your results. Are you ready for your second balloon activity today? This one is called balloon rockets, and you are going to need the following supplies to do this activity. You're going to need a pair of scissors. You're going to need a straw. You're going to need some kind of string or yarn. I actually have fishing wire that I'm going to be using today. Some markers, tape, and of course, the all-important balloon. Do you have those things? Are you ready? Okay, let's do the first step. The first thing you're going to need to do is you're going to need to measure your yarn or string or your fishing wire the length of a space that you have available. And it's going to need to be attached to a wall, to a chair, somewhere off of the ground. And I'm gonna go ahead and tape one end of mine to the wall over there. And you can attach yours wherever you would like. Okay, now, before you attach your second end to the wall or to the chair, I want you to take your straw and I want you to thread it onto your string. So I'm gonna poke it through there. See that right there? See how I've got my straw threaded on? That's exactly what I need you to do. Now I can go safely secure the other end of my string. Now what I need you to remember is you are going to need to keep your string pretty tight in order for these to be successful. Now the next thing that I need you to do is I want you to very carefully blow up your balloon, but we're not going to tie a knot in it just yet. I want you to blow it up and hold that closed. There we go. See how I'm just holding onto the end there? And then just for fun, I want you to decorate your balloon. There we go. Nice and simple. Now I'm gonna very carefully let my balloon deflate. Do you remember that straw that we attached to the string a few moments ago? I need you to attach two pieces of tape very carefully to the top of that straw at both ends. When you've done that, we'll be ready to move on. So now that we're all completely set up, let's explore wind power. So inside the balloon, when we blow it up, we fill it with air, and that becomes potential energy. We're gonna change that potential energy into kinetic energy, and we're gonna make our rockets fly across the room. There we go. I'm not going to go too big this time. That's for you to experiment with here in a moment. So I've blown up my balloon and I'm holding it closed. Now we need to know which end is the front of our rocket and which end is the back of our rocket. The easy way to remember that is where you are holding right now, that is the back of the rocket. So if I want my rocket to fly this way, when I attach it to my straw, I'm going to make sure that my back end is pointing the opposite direction. So we're going to bring our straw in here and we're going to very carefully, while still holding it closed, attach it to our straw. We want to make sure that the balloon stays on the bottom of our string. And it should look something like this. Now I'm going to pull it back to the start of my launch pad. I want to count down from three, and when I say blast off, you're going to let go. Ready? 3, 2, 1, blast off. Woo! My rocket flew across the room. How about yours? You want to do it again? Perfect. Let's go again. So we took all of that stored potential energy, which was the air that we blew into our balloon, and we turned it into kinetic energy, which means movement. And it was a whole lot of fun. You know what the best part is? You can do this over and over again, and you can even have races. All that you would need to do is set up a second line exactly the way you have right now next to yours, and you can have races to see whose rocket is going to blast off the furthest and fastest. Now this time, try making your balloon bigger or smaller and see how that affects how your rocket flies. You ready? 3, 2, 1, blast off! Woo! I think I'm going to need to make a bigger blast off path for my rocket ship. How did yours turn out? I can't wait to see your rockets in action. For our third balloon activity today, you're going to need one more balloon and a couple of pennies. And you're probably going to need an adult helper for the first part as well. So the first thing we're going to do is we are going to blow up our balloon so that we can get it nice and stretchy. There we go, let's get it all stretched out. All right. Now, what you're going to need to do is you're going to need to stretch open that opening of your balloon and very carefully put a penny. That's right, you're going to drop your penny inside that balloon. Now, the first time, we're just going to put one penny in there and we're going to discover what we can do with our forces of motion. So now that your penny's in there, you're going to blow up your balloon and you're going to have someone help you tie a knot in your balloon so that everything stays nice and secure. There we go. So I've got my knot in my balloon and I've got a penny in the bottom. Now, what are we going to do with this penny? Well, we are going to explore our forces of emotion. So our emotion and our forces. So we can shake it around in there and it does lots of things. But I want to challenge you to see if you can get that coin spinning around all by itself without you having to do anything else. You want to try it out? There we go, that's one way. Did you get it? There are a couple of ways of doing this, but you want to try and get that coin so it's spinning around all by itself. And you can see it in there spinning around. I did it. Now it kind of makes a fun little noise as it does it too. This is what we call centripetal force. That means that that coin is going to keep spinning all by itself until another force acts upon it. In this case, it's friction of the balloon, and that's what's going to slow it down, and then it's going to stop moving. But that's so neat. We can kind of get it spinning in one direction. Can you get it spinning in the other direction? Fantastic. So have fun with your balloon and that one penny. See how many different ways you can get that penny spinning around inside of that balloon, even though you've stopped that motion. So this time, I actually have two coins inside of my balloon. And I want to see what happens when there's two coins in there instead of one. Remember, we're going to record and observe our results just by using our eyes and then using our words. Ready? Let's try two coins. See if we can get them going. It's a little bit different with two coins. Wow. So my coins stayed together the entire time and followed the same pattern. What did your coins do? Is it different if we just shake it? What about if we spin it a different way? There's lots of different ways you can play with this. And plus, it's pretty fun to watch those coins whizzing around in there. I can't wait to see you check this out, guys. Have fun! So that was three fun, simple activities that we did together today, and they all included the balloon. Which one was your favorite? I love the self-inflating one, but the rocket is awesome fun too. I highly recommend setting up two and having races. Let me know in the comments which one your favorite was, and hopefully I'll see you next time. Bye!